In this video, I'll show you how to monitor a standalone Nginx instance. It's not as easy as you may think. In the first graph, we use P99, P90 and P50 percentiles. For example, P90 percentile means that 90% of all requests are completed under specified duration. The second graph shows the traffic measured in requests per second. Finally, the third one shows availability of your service. It's just a ratio between successful and total requests. Your application will always return some number of failed requests, but in case your availability fails to lower than 80%, you should send alert and investigate. You can use Grafana variables to switch between different paths. You can also use wildcards for routes or just select all of them. The same applies to the status codes. In my definition, successful status codes are between 2 and 300 and failed requests between 4 and 500. And finally, you can also filter by HTTP methods such as GET, POST, PUT, and of course, you can add more. Now, the biggest issue with monitoring Nginx is that those metrics are not exposed. Only the enterprise version of Nginx Plus emits some useful metrics. Now, these metrics are actually open source Nginx exposes. Active connections and total requests are more or less useful, but it's not even close enough to what I want to monitor. Let me explain how to get application-specific metrics, such as request duration, error rate, and others. Alright, first of all, we'll install Nginx on Ubuntu 22.04 LTS. We'll use standard Nginx stub status module to create a page with basic stats, such as active connections and total request count. To convert those numbers to Prometheus metrics, we'll use Nginx Prometheus exporter and configure it to scrape Nginx status page. Then it converts those metrics and exposes them on port 9113 as Prometheus metrics. To scrape them, we'll of course would need to install Prometheus. Now, to get more useful metrics such as latency, we'll update Nginx access log format and install a FluentD agent on the same box where we have Nginx. Unfortunately, FluentBit doesn't have this capability just yet. Using regex expression, we'll convert log entries to the Prometheus metrics and expose them on the port 24231 on the same VM. In this case, Prometheus can directly scrape those metrics. Now, if you have a single Nginx, you can install Nginx Prometheus exporter on it as well. If you have multiple instances, you can keep it as standalone and scrape all Nginx servers from one place. I agree, it looks a little bit more complex than it should. In the following video, we'll build a custom Prometheus exporter from scratch to replace Nginx Prometheus exporter and FluentD altogether. Subscribe to my channel if you like content like this. If you want to follow along, you need a Linux box. Preferably, you would use Ubuntu 22.04 LTS as I do. You can use VirtualBox to create it locally or maybe somewhere in the clouds. You can also use my Terraform code to create AWS VPC, Internet Gateway, a single public subnet, routes, and EC2 instance. You can find the source code in my GitHub repository, which will cost you less than a dollar to run per day. If you decide to use my code to SSH to the instance, you don't need SSH keys. Simply add this Amazon SSM managed instance core policy to your EC2 instance and use session manager to SSH. Now let's initialize the Terraform and apply. In a few minutes, you should have your EC2 instance. It may take up to 5 minutes for EC2 instance to show up in the session manager window. You can start a session from the AWS console, or I prefer to use CLI command. To use CLI, you would need to install Session Manager plugin. To install the latest stable Nginx version, we need to add official Nginx repository. First of all, before installing Nginx itself, we need to install some prerequisites. Import official Nginx signing key so app could verify the packages. Verify that downloaded file contains the proper key. If the fingerprint is different, remove the file. To set up apt repository for stable Nginx packages, run the following command. To install Nginx, run the following command. Let's make sure that the basic metric module is configured with the Nginx. You should be able to find with HTTP stop status module in the output. If you don't have it, you need to compile Nginx with this module or use dynamic modules. Let's check if the Nginx is running. In case it's not, let's start it. Now, it should be in running state. Let's use Ubuntu IP address to check if you can access Nginx. Let's create a new Nginx configuration file to add additional server block with our metric module. If you use a different method to install Nginx, for example, default Ubuntu packages, you might have a different location for Nginx configuration files. Before creating a file, let me switch to the root Linux user. Later, we'll adjust Linux permissions and ownership. Now, the configuration file. Optionally, you can restrict this plugin to emit metrics to only the localhost. It may be useful if you have a single Nginx instance and you install Prometheus Exporter on it as well. In case you have multiple Nginx servers, it's better to deploy Prometheus Exporter on a separate instance and scrape all of them from a single exporter. We'll use location Nginx directive to expose basic metrics on port 8080/status page. Always verify if the configuration is valid before restarting Nginx. To update Nginx config without downtime, you can use reload command. Now we can access 8080/status page. Unfortunately, open source Nginx server only exposes these not very useful metrics. I guess I would pay attention only to the active connections metric from here. They decided to only provide meaningful metrics in the enterprise version of Nginx, which is called Nginx Plus. I'll show you how to get around later in this tutorial. Still, let's fetch all the available metrics for now. We'll use Nginx Prometheus Exporter to do that. It's a Golang application that compiles to a single binary without external dependencies, which is very easy to install. First of all, let's create a folder for the exporter and switch directory. As a best practice, you should always create a dedicated user for each application that you want to run. Let's call it Nginx Exporter User and a group. From the releases pages on GitHub, let's find the latest version and copy the link to the appropriate archive. In my case, it's a standard AMD 64 platform. We can use curl to download exporter on the Ubuntu machine. Extract Prometheus Exporter from the archive. You can also remove it to save some space. Let's make sure that we downloaded the correct binary by checking the version of the exporter. It's optional, let's update the ownership on the exporter folder. To run it, let's also create a systemd service file. In case it exits, systemd manager can restart it. It's a standard way to run Linux daemons. Make sure you update scrape URI to the one that you used in Nginx to expose basic metrics. Also, update Linux user and group to match yours in case you use different names. Enable the servers to automatically start the daemon on Linux restart. Then start the Nginx Prometheus exporter. Check the status of the servers. If your exporter fails to start, you can check logs to find the error message. To verify that Prometheus exporter can access Nginx and properly scrape metrics, use curl command and default 9113 port for the exporter. Now, you should be able to get the same metrics from the status page, but in Prometheus format. Let's quickly install the latest version of Prometheus on the same host. Create a dedicated Linux user for Prometheus. Let's check the latest version of Prometheus from the download page. You can use curl or wget command to download Prometheus. Then we need to extract all Prometheus files from the archive. Usually, you will have a disk mounted to the data directory. For this tutorial, I'll simply create a data directory. Also, you need a folder for Prometheus configuration files. Now, let's change the directory to Prometheus and move some files. First of all, let's move Prometheus binary and prompt tool to the user local bin. Prompt tool is used to check configuration files and Prometheus rules. Optionally, we can move console libraries to the Prometheus configuration directory. Console templates allow for creation of arbitrary consoles using Go templating language. You don't need to worry about if you're just getting started. Finally, let's move the example of the main Prometheus configuration file. To avoid permission issues, you need to set correct ownership for the etc Prometheus and data directory. Optionally, you can clean up and delete the archive itself and unused files. Verify that you can execute Prometheus binary by running the following command. We're going to use systemd, which is a system and service manager for Linux operating systems. For that, we need to create a systemd unit configuration file. Make sure you're using the correct username and group. Also, check the data path. Before we launch Prometheus, let's add our Nginx Prometheus exporter as a target. Update the job name to Nginx Prometheus exporter and port to 9113. To automatically start Prometheus after reboot, run enable. Then just start the Prometheus. To check the status of Prometheus, run the following command. Now go to 9090/ to check if Prometheus is working. Under the target section, you should have a single Nginx Prometheus exporter target. Now you can query your metrics from the Prometheus Explorer tab. For example, you can use Nginx underscore connections underscore active to get active Nginx connections. The next step is to install Grafana, which is much simpler since we can use official repository. First, let's make sure that all the dependencies are installed. Next, add GPG key. Add this repository for stable releases. After you add repository, update and install Grafana. To automatically start Grafana after reboot, enable the service. Then start the Grafana. To check the status of Grafana, run the following command. Now you can access Grafana on port 3000. The username is admin and the password is admin as well. First of all, let's add our Prometheus as a data source. For the URL, use HTTP localhost 9090 and click Save and Test. Let's create a new dashboard and call Nginx. Create a new panel. For the metrics, use Nginx connections active. For the legend, instance. Title, active connections. I'm going to fill out the rest of the panels using the metrics that we retrieved from the status page. You can find this dashboard in my GitHub repository. On the left-hand side, we have all the gauges and on the right-hand side, all the counters. To make use of a counter, you need to apply a rate function, for example, to calculate a number of requests per second. The next step is to install Fluentd and convert Nginx logs to Prometheus metrics. First of all, we need to install the Ruby programming language. Verify that Ruby is installed successfully. You need at least 2.7 Ruby version. Now we can install Fluentd itself using gem, which is a standard way for Ruby to distribute packages. Install Fluentd plugin to convert logs to Prometheus metrics. Verify Fluentd installation. You should get the latest version. Create a folder to place Fluentd config. Let's update Nginx access log to emit additional values. Add upstream response time at the end of the log, but better replace the whole string with main to avoid any typos. Let's save and restart Nginx. Now we need to create a regular expression to parse Nginx access logs. First, let's get a sample from the log and use one of the online regex editors. Since we don't have any upstream services, the last value is empty for now. Let's use regex101.com to create the regular expression. Paste your log sample and enter regular expression. On the right-hand side, you'll see the named parameters, such as status code, method, size, and others. Some of them we'll use as a labels in Prometheus. Now, let's create a Fluentd config. You'll find the metric sections where we convert logs to Prometheus metrics. For example, to measure latency, we use Nginx HTTP request duration seconds. Create the last systemd service unit for the FluentD to run it in the background. Let's run it as a root to grant access to Nginx logs. Of course, I would advise you to downgrade to its own user. As always, enable, start, and check the status. You can access Prometheus metrics on localhost 24.231/metrics. Let's add another Prometheus target to scrape FluentD. Restart Prometheus. Now you should have two targets in Prometheus UI. For the final test, let's create a simple Flask app to test our metrics. Install pip package manager for Python if you don't have it yet. Install Flask, which is HTTP framework for Python. Install GUnicore, which is a production-grade server for Flask applications. Create a folder for the app. Now let's create the app itself. It's a very simple HTTP API that has a single API/devices endpoint and supports get and post methods. Also, we simulate a load by generating the random sleep interval. Create a dedicated user for the Flask app. Update ownership on the folder. Create systemd service for the app. Enable, start, and check the app. Now check if you have access to the Flask app locally. The next step is to use Nginx as a reverse proxy for our app. Let's also add a few headers, just in case the Flask needs to know where the request is coming from. Remove the default Nginx config with the Hello World page. Test and reload Nginx config. Now we can use Nginx IP address to test the app. Finally, let's create a few more Grafana dashboards to use these metrics. You can import my dashboards that you can find in the GitHub repo. In the following video, we'll build a custom Prometheus exporter from scratch to replace the Nginx Prometheus exporter and FluentD agent altogether. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.